and welcome back to Sister Circle Live. One of the most popular things for families to do during the summer months is to go to the beach. Fun. But instead of just hitting any old beach this season, why not go to a black beach? Yes, for that trip around a historically black beach. Here to tell us about the rich history and culture associated with some of those beaches is our resident travel expert and beauty queen, Dayvee Sutton.
Well, thank you. Hey.
Yes, you will get your life down here at the Circle.
That's
you better
it.
Let them
yeah.
know.
Yes,
okay.
All right. Thank you.
What is a historically black beach? I personally have never heard of it. I don't. Am I going to get my black card?
No,
that's
no,
right.
It's not.
I really, honest,
well, that's why
goodness.
I'm presenting it to yeah. you okay. today. I don't think a lot of us know about that. But we do know that not so long ago, segregation was very real in this country.
Yes,
so
it was.
In order for people of color to lounge and even swim in the water in the beach, they were restricted. And so I wanted to give you guys a little bit of places that were historically where black people had access to and where you can still take your families today.
Wow,
you know,
I didn't
for
know
the
that.
Culture.
Yes,
okay.
Absolutely. So we have such a rich culture as African Americans, including where we vacation for centuries. And a lot of people know about Martha's Vineyard, of
yes.
course. But for years now, there are actually some black beaches or homes that were owned by black people in Martha's Vineyard. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, let's talk about the Hamptons, because
okay.
the Hamptons is a very popular playground for the rich and famous.
Yes.
We know about Diddy's parties.
Yes.
We know about all of those things. Well, consider Sag Harbor was
okay.
the black corner of that beachfront.
Ah.
So after World War II,
look,
don't you love
picture.
These
yes.
vintage pictures? After World War II, black people started buying property and started building a robust community.
Mm-hmm.
And so over the years, of course, they've been
wow.
fighting off gentrification, but there's still a strong black community, as you see in this photo right here.
Yes.
And if you go there, you can go to the Eastville Historical Society, and they have those pictures that they were gracious to let me use them on the show today. They have those pictures there
wow.
that we saw, and you can learn more about the black community there.
Sag Harbor.
Sag Harbor in New York State.
Now,
yes.
you mentioned Diddy's white parties in the Hamptons and all of that, but why do you think that black people have been able to hold on to their property in Sag Harbor?
Mm-hmm. Well, the initial people who had access, who had leisure, who had the funds to gain access to the beach were people who were upper and middle class families.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So they were the first residents. So they've been trying to fight off gentrification since, and Sag Harbor is considered more mixed now, but there's still a robust community there.
Good.
And the same thing that you mentioned earlier, Martha's Vineyard, those fancy places where fancy black people went, there's still a strong community there.
Okay,
wow.
good. We gotta hold on.
Hold on.
Yeah, hold on, keep on keeping on, baby. Okay, so let's move on to the history of African Americans and tourism in Florida.
Right, Florida is all beach, right?
Yes.
I love Florida.
Oh, love Florida.
The
love
first
it.
Black beach in Florida is called American Beach.
Uh-huh.
On Amelia Island, mm-hmm. just outside of Jacksonville.
Yes.
And the person who founded that was a man named Abraham Lincoln Lewis. He was Florida's first black billionaire, and he founded American Beach. He bought it as a place of refuge for his friends and for his family to go, and also celebrities. You can find celebrities down there
yeah.
like Ray Charles, Zora Neale Hurston, Hank Aaron, and today the streets are named after some of those early African-American families and
yeah,
founders.
Yeah, that's great. I'm
yeah.
going to be in Jacksonville a little bit later on this month. Maybe we'll hit up Amelia Island for that.
Yeah,
Amelia
Island, look for American Beach. And of course, you can find, you'll see the history start revealing itself there on the streets.
Yes.
So American Beach is the first black beach in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
What was the first African-American beach in the United States, period?
That is considered Highland Beach
mm-hmm.
in Chesapeake, Maryland, which is about 35 minutes outside of Washington, D.C. And Highland Beach was founded by the son of one of our American heroes, Frederick Douglass.
Wow!
Yes!
Yes.
He and his wife, they founded it in 1893. They had this beach. And so you can still learn more about Highland Beach and Twin Oaks, which is the Frederick Douglass Museum and Cultural Center.
That is fantastic.
I did not know that.
I
that
know.
That is freaking me out.
I'm here to educate
yes.
you.
Yes. Educate the people.
Wow.
So, you know, I'm from a rich history of Gullah Geechee people from Charleston, South Carolina.
Yeah.
So I know all about it. We used to swim on Folly Beach. Tell us about the Gullah Geechee Heritage Corridor.
Right, so that is the area that starts from about the south of North Carolina through South Carolina to the top of Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And it is the descendants of people from Central and West Africa who were enslaved. Like all of us, we're the descendants of people who were enslaved, but because they're in that corridor, it was considered throwaway land, marshland.
Mm-hmm.
So they were pretty isolated. And because they were isolated, they were able to hold on to a good amount of their African ancestry. So they still, to this day, have their their own language,
yes,
their own dance, their own culture. So if you visit areas like Hilton Head, Savannah, mm-hmm. Charleston, you'll be able to see some of the Gullah Geechee people.
Yes.
Well, we have,
I didn't know that.
And they're considered the African Americans who have the most intact African heritage. So you go visit the museums there, but you will see the people around. They'll have their basket weaving.
Yes.
And they love to tell the story.
Right. You know, I used to, when I was younger, when we would go visit my grandparents, I would go crabbing with the chicken on the
roll.
Are
you serious?
Yes, and the big, and go back and put those blue crabs in my grandmama's pot, bought them things, and we eat those things right there.
What? Yes, and we, on my show Beyond the Usual, we did a whole episode on the Gullah Geechee culture there.
Yes, honey, I love it. And I love when my daddy starts to bring out his accent when he's around his people. Yes. Honey, it's the best thing ever.
Yes, I tried to learn it when I was there and speak it a bit.
How many beaches have you been to, black beaches have you been to?
Oh, so the thing is, there are so many historical markers around the country, the black beaches. I'm always discovering them. They're not really advertised.
Wow.
So I was just one, there's one called Lido Beach in Sarasota, and I didn't even know that, and I happened upon it and saw the market there.
So. Well, thank you so much for just divulging all this amazing information for our good people to go to a black beach
this summer. I gotta go.
Right.
I gotta get the beach body to go with the beach.
You got the body. Don't even worry about it. For more great information and vacation ideas, you can follow Dayvee Sutton. That's right, on the at Dayvee Sutton. And season 2 of Dayvee's Travel Show Beyond the Usual debuts in July on Amazon Prime Video.